Hello and welcome back to another episode of Your Drone Questions Answered. I'm John Dicko, here to answer your drone questions. Today's question is, how is someone supposed to be able to get into mapping when DroneDeploy and PIX4D are insanely expensive per month? A little guy like me definitely can't afford $4.99 monthly subscriptions, even with the annual plan still being $3.29 a month. Are there any alternatives that I just don't know about because I'm new? This is coming from Steve at River City Drones. Today, I have with me David Young, founder of Drone Lunch Academy, here to help me answer this question. David, thanks for joining me today.
Yeah, thanks for having me on, John. And this is a very good and relevant question, one that's come up a lot. When I saw it come through, I said, oh, hey, John, we got to answer this question because I see it a lot. We actually just had a live event this weekend in Lakeland, Florida, a bunch of Drone Launch Academy and Drone Launch Connect people in person. We did a mapping workshop and this literal exact question came up. So I've already been on top of it for a while and researched it. So the answer is yes, DroneDeploy and PIX4D have, well, PIX4D has always been kind of expensive. DroneDeploy has become very expensive. Actually, I don't know when Steve, who asked this question, checked the pricing, but DroneDeploy is actually even a little bit more expensive now than what he said. It's $4.99 per month if you get the annual subscription. So really it's $6,000 a year or $600 per month. So it's pretty expensive. And PIX4D, the cloud comes in, I think it's around $250 a month for like the PIX4D Cloud Advanced, which gives you, you know, most of the options. And they do sort of like a credit system based on the size of the map you're doing. You can get a PIX4D Cloud like basic version, which allows you to do smaller maps. And that's cheaper. I think that's around like $60 a month. So that is one option maybe he's not aware of. So those are two of the most common ones on the kind of upper end of the spectrum. And, you know, they do a lot of, they're at every conference, they're at all these things, they promote a lot, therefore people know about them. But there are smaller companies maybe, or maybe less known mapping software providers, photogrammetry software is really what it is. And two that I've found that are good alternatives are Maps Made Easy. They've been around for a pretty long time. I think they're from California. We actually use them for our drone mapping and modeling fundamentals course for this exact reason. You know, most people, if they're just getting into it, they're not going to want to spend $600 a month to learn. So we use Maps Made Easy, and it's a pay as you go type of system. So you can do very small maps, or at least maybe you used to, for free, like up to a certain point, like really small ones. And beyond that, you just buy some credits and then you use those credits to be able to process your map. And the credits are based on how many gigapixels you're using. So it's essentially the resolution of your camera times the number of pictures you have that you're wanting to turn into a map, right? So how much data are you giving it to process? So Maps Made Easy is one. They've been around for a while and they're okay. It's definitely not as good a quality as the others as far as the tools that you get, right? DroneDeploy and PIX4D, one of the main things about them that is really great and that people love is all the tools you can use after you process that 3D model or map. They have a lot of analysis tools, right? You can calculate the volume, you can measure stuff, you can annotate things, you can share with other people. It's good collaboration, good analysis. Some of these other processing tools, they're just going to create the map for you, create the model, and then kind of hand you the file, right? Maps Made Easy, they have some really basic, you can measure a straight line or measure a circle type of thing, but nothing super advanced. So Maps Made Easy is one. And the other one I want to talk about is a newer one that I found called Birdie, B-I-R-D-I. They're an Australian company, and I reached out to them because I found them and I started looking into it. I was like, oh, this actually looks like a pretty good alternative. So I reached out to them, struck up a conversation. They're super great, very collaborative. I've been working with some people there on maybe integrating some of their stuff or using their software in some of our courses, right, in addition to Maps Made Easy. And it's a similar thing where they have a free plan where it's pay as you go, and it's pretty inexpensive to do, right? You can process a small map for only a few dollars. So if you're just getting started out, or even if you're getting jobs and you need to process this stuff and you don't want to spend a bunch of money on a subscription, or maybe the jobs aren't coming in that well yet, you can do this pay-as-you-go processing and still generate 3D models and maps. You might just have to get a little creative with what you use for analysis. But there are free tools out there like Google Earth Pro that you can export things into and, you know, play around in there. There's things like QGIS. There's other kind of free software tools, again, that are still kind of, you know, not as good as some of the paid ones, but it gives you options for if you're just starting out. So the two ends of the spectrum, I'd say, are PIX4D Cloud, DroneDeploy on the high end, and then Birdie and Maps Made Easy on the lower end as far as price goes. Now, there are a few other options out there, right? There are things like reality capture and things that you can do for specifically like creating 3D models. You can view things in another app called Nira View and make measurements. So you can check that out. I believe reality capture is also kind of a pay-as-you-go type system. but they're owned by a company that makes video games. So that's more for like 3D visualizations, I believe, versus kind of creating orthomosaic maps. So that's kind of a good general overview. One other thing I was going to say, if you're a student, Pix4D has great student pricing. So if you're just learning and you also happen to be enrolled in a university as an undergraduate or graduate student, if you sign up with your .edu email address, I mean, it's super cheap. Like Pix4D Mapper, which is another software that Pix4D makes that goes on your computer. And, you know, normally you send the images off and they process everything and create the orthomosaic images and do all that analysis, or they do all the processing on their servers. But Pix4D Mapper is a software you install on your computer, and you have to have a pretty big computer to handle it, and it does all the work on your own machine. But it gives you more control over how everything is stitched together, right? You can kind of play with it a little bit more. That normally costs like $3,000 a year, I believe, that software does. But if you're a student, I think it's around $100 for a year. So it's like crazy cheap. And then Pix4D Cloud Advanced, if you want to do the student pricing, it's $500 a year. That's the only option they offer, which seems, maybe that seems like a lot. But if you were to do that same thing on just a regular purchase, it would be $3,000 per year or $300 per month. So definitely a huge discount there. DroneDeploy doesn't have those same kind of discounts. So if you are a student, I would highly recommend grabbing some of those Pix4D discounts if you're going to be using mapping software. So I could get into more detail on some of these, but that's kind of the general outlay for your mapping software options.
Absolutely. And I mean, definitely take advantage if you're a student, but you bring up a great point when it comes to these other softwares you mentioned, like Maps Made Easy and Birdie. These pay-as-you-go features on a need basis seem like it's almost less of a commitment for a beginner. It almost work out better than paying that much per year and really having to commit in that kind of way. So that's actually a really good alternative.
Yeah. And I will say too, Birdie has some, you can get paid plans, and I think Maps Made Easy might have this as well, where you can pay for a subscription that makes their processing cheaper than if you didn't have a subscription. So if you like using them, you could like pay for a subscription and then reduce your processing costs anyways, even from there. And I think that would probably still work out cheaper than getting something like DroneDeploy or whatever. I will say this, most of the people I know who are doing bigger, more regular mapping jobs as like a living, right? The full-time living, they pay the $6,000 or whatever it is for DroneDeploy, or they pay the money for Pix4D, the full-on stuff, because it really does help them with their clients and they're able to turn it into a profitable venture once they've ramped up. But yeah, I totally understand starting out at the beginning, having a need for something cheaper.
Great. Well, excellent suggestions, Dave, but I really appreciate it. You nailed this one. Steve, I hope we answered your question. I hope you're satisfied with that one. And don't forget, you can submit your own questions. We'll find the answers to your drone questions. You can submit those questions at ydqa.io or go ahead and shoot us a message over the Drone Launch Connect private community. We'd see it. We'll find the answer. In the meantime, we'll see you in the sky.